Talk about a creepy smile. That's a clip from Chris Cunningham's 1999 music video for Aphex Twin's Window Licker.
So why are smiles like this so deeply disturbing?
We're constantly bombarded by smiles. The smile of a loving partner, the ridiculous forced smirk of a toddler, the disingenuous car salesman grin, the dead-eyed newscaster smile, and the sinister leer of a movie villain.
Our faces, after all, are communication arrays. Think of it as the blank slate on which we write the script of our expressions and micro-expressions.
But here's the thing, there are two types of smiles. First, you have the Duchenne smile, named for French physician Guillaume Duchenne, who conducted a slew of experiments electrocuting people's facial muscles into outrageous grins.
That electrical current activates contractions in two muscles, the voluntary zygomatic major, which raises the corners of the mouth, and the involuntary orbicularis oculi, which raises the cheeks and spreads crow's feet around the eyes.
Now, I realize the electrical current bit is a bit weird, but for all intents and purposes, that's a genuine smile, because when we fake a smile for customer service or a family photo, we're only contracting the zygomatic major, since we cannot voluntarily contract the orbicularis oculi.
But can we tell the difference? Are creepy smiles creepy because we can see through the con? A 2013 study from the University of La Laguna, Spain investigated. They found that, on first glance, test subjects had a very hard time recognizing a fake smile.
But the longer they looked at the individual, taking in all the details of the expression, the more they saw through the ruse. However, in 40% of the cases, test subjects ultimately classified ambiguous smiles as happy, since their eyes were drawn more to the smile itself than to the eyes.
So how can you consciously detect a fake smile? Well, according to body language expert Nicholas Frade, look to the crow's feet. Look for the bottom of a person's teeth, and if you can see them, well, it might be a fake smile.
And remember, the involuntary movements of the orbicularis oculi are key. This can cause the eyes to close during a genuine smile, while fake smilers often keep their upper face very still. And if that doesn't work, MIT's Media Lab has developed an algorithm that allows machines to pinpoint fake happiness and fake frustration.
But don't poo-poo fake smiles just yet. A 2012 study from the University of Kansas studied how smiling influences our recovery from stressful activities. They found that a genuine smile resulted in faster recovery times and a more relaxed state, but even a fake smile can force your emotional state, well, to follow suit.
So fake it till you make it, as they say. Just try not to look like a creeper.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out these three videos as well.
And don't forget to visit us at stufftoblowyourmind.com. When we see someone smile, mirror neurons simulate our own smiling, and smiling is actually one of the most important nonverbal communication skills we possess, and it's sort of like a social contract that we enter into with others. We're communicating to others that everything is a-okay. Nothing to see here. Move on.
Banshee resting face denotes a woman who looks thoughtfully sad or angry for no reason. There have been many times in my life when my face that looks like this has been mistaken for me wanting to rip something to shreds.
The expression for disgust is identical in different cultures across the globe, essentially screwing up our noses and pulling down the corners of our mouths.